All right, if you're ready for your next comedian, say hell yeah. Coming to the stage all the way from Ohio, but that's a lie. This brother lives out in Chandler. Do me a favor and put your hands together for the very funny Spider Jones.
Always messes up where I'm from. He changes my location every damn time. My girl live in Chandler. I live in South Mountain, all right? I still use coupons to go to Wendy's. She don't. Y'all, you got to change that, man. Looking at y'all right now, y'all probably like thought I was going to be some 300-pound biker with neck tattoos. People hear my name, Spider Jones, think I'm about to come out, think I'm in a biker gang. Then you see me and be like, oh, crackhead. I'd be like, no. I think it's messed up, man. Like, I'm 45 with a high school name, and I try to be better. But also, it doesn't help that I'm 45, never been married, no kids. And white people hear that, be like, wow, that's amazing. Black people hear that and just assume I'm gay. Like, I always know the holidays are coming up when my aunt asked me, are you going to come to church with us after Thanksgiving? I got someone you want to meet. I was like, no. There's only so many choir directors I can tell you I'm good, bruh. Gee. Be real, man. I love the fact that I'm 45, but I realize some things have been changing since I hit my 40s. Like I realized that, like, I'm getting real paranoid about some things. Like, I'm not worried about dying. I'm just more worried about where they're going to find my body. I'm skinny, I work out, but every now and then I have those big kid urges. Like, I'll sit in front of the TV and watch Grey's Anatomy eating a whole pint of ice cream. But what happens if that pint is the last pint and I die? The ambulance gonna find me a week later because I'm a comic. No one loves me, so no one's gonna come find my fucking body until then. I'm gonna be laying on the couch dead. They're not gonna come in and be like, ice cream, heart attack, so sad. Let's call his family. No, they gonna walk in and be like, skinny, black, spoon, crackhead, overdose, wrap it up. Right? I'm paranoid about things I shouldn't be paranoid about. I don't know about you. I got real paranoid one day. I walked into a KFC and I slowly backed out because it was an all-white staff. I don't know why I was worried they wasn't gonna use all 11 herbs and spices. It's a chain, it comes in a bag. I walked in, I knew something was wrong, but it was like, welcome to KFC, how can I help you? I was like, polite service, something don't feel right. You ever pull up to the drive-thru somewhere, and you know your order's gonna be messed up by how the tone is when it comes through the speaker? Went to a Burger King on 19th, as soon as I rode, he was like, what up, man? I was like, nah, bruh, nah. The food gonna taste amazing, but it's not gonna be your order. Oh, man. And fellas, I don't know about y'all. Oh, man, I had a bad revelation one day. Fellas, you ever been at the barbershop getting your hair cut, minding your business? Everything cool, the barber talking to you? And all of a sudden, you feel the barber's dick on your arm? Ladies, that's a real thing. See, my stepmom owns a bunch of salons back east. So I know when y'all go, you get pampered because you're there all day. They bring you drinks. You got people to bring you food. They talking to you. You feel safe. You feel comfortable. Barbershop, you get that. Hey, what's up, bro? You cool? Yeah. Hey, come on, man. I got you. You see the game the other day? Yeah, man. LeBron's still doing it in his 40s. And then he comes around to the side. And then his voice get real soft. And then all of a sudden, you just hear, don't move. I don't want to nick you. And then you just feel. And you got to make a decision as a guy. You got to make a decision. Get up, stand your ground, and leave with a messed up haircut. Or be gay for 7 minutes. So I just cut my own hair now. I can't keep buying flags. You know, times are crazy, man. I get parent, like I said, man, I'm just getting parent. I don't know about you. You ever see an Amber Alert and pray it don't match your car? Good I'm not the only one. Because that alert go off, and you just be like, who? And it's like playing lottery with your life. Like, I remember the first time I got here, I didn't realize I moved here, and I saw y'all got the amber alerts on the screen. And they flashing like the lottery numbers, like, we looking for a 2007. Ford. I'm going to jail. F-150. Looking for that last piece of information, like it's that last lottery number. It was like, blue. I was like, oh, dear God, Jesus, mine is white. Thank you. And I pull off the road in case it's a typo. You ever see the Amber Alert and then start looking for that car like you Batman? Like, that's the day you're going to save baby Sarah. But then you look at your gas tank. Got to make a decision. Oh, man. I'm trying to be a better person, man, but then I see things like that, and it gets me thinking. You got Amber Alerts now. It's 2024, we had Amber Alerts. I'm 45. My generation, we didn't have Amber Alerts. You know why? Because nobody wanted us. You know how we knew nobody wanted us? Because our parents told us every damn chance they got. Who was bold enough to ever say, I'm a runaway? What'd your parents say? Well, go. I'll repack your bags, bitch. Bye. I was like, I was just playing. It's Wednesday. What you doing? You know? And it wasn't. It's just different. Things are just different now. Like it's crazy. Like, we could go outside and ride our bikes with all our friends, all 27 of them. Y'all knew the house. Everybody's bike was on the hill or whoever's house was meeting at. You get on your bikes and you ride for 4, 5, 7 states, depending on where you was at. And it didn't matter how long it took you. You knew exactly how long you had to get home. Because when did you have to be home? And we learned something that kids don't know today. It's called street math. And you had that one friend who had a PhD. Because he was like a native. It didn't matter what time it was. He'll feel the wind blow, look up in the sky, be like, oh, bruh, it's 5:37. Sun goes down in 32 minutes. We got to go. Oh, God. Man, I'm telling you, man, it's crazy how things are now. I think it's kind of crazy that, like, kids are getting bullied in the bitchiest of ways. Because we got bullied by our parents. You don't think about it until now. Our parents are our first bullies. You don't remember when they took you to the store? Right? See, some of y'all haven't, I'm sorry if y'all having PTSD. I'm sorry. But you be all happy to go outside. They wait until the last minute and then grab you like this and be like, now listen here. When we get inside, don't look for nothing. Don't touch nothing. Don't ask for nothing. And if you do any of those things, I'ma beat your ass. And I'm sitting there in my mouth, why you bring me? You know I want cereal. But that's how I was, man. If you weren't bullied by your parents, you was bullied by your friends. I thought me and my friends were cool. But then I didn't realize that we were subtle differences. Like, I didn't realize that my friends were all hood, and I come from a neighborhood. It's called hood adjacent now, but I came from a neighborhood. I had things my friends didn't have, like a house, cable, color TVs, two parents. I'm telling you. I didn't know that was a thing. I didn't know what food stamps was until I saw my boys in line paying for it. I thought that shit was Monopoly money. I saw my friend pay for food with food stamps. I thought it was, I went home, got all the money out of the Monopoly game. Went to school the next day, was like, hey, tater tots on me. Damn. But then I noticed something happened. My father came to pick me up. Surprised to pick me up one day. I saw my friends. I was like, hey, my father's here. I got to go. And one friend was like, your stepdad? I was like, no, my father. And it was like, oh, it's his weekend to have you? I was like, every weekend is his weekend to have me. I live with him. He probably just got out. It was like, a prison? I was like, a work? I don't like where these questions are coming from. We're probably going to go pick up my mom. She's getting out, too. They was like, a rehab? I said, a work, Ricky? What the fuck? Hey, I'm going to be selling these stickers after the show. I'm Spider Jones. Thank you very much.